He will be in the midst. I want to tell somebody right now that you will never be disappointed, because our God, the Creator, not only He can create us, but He can sustain what He has started is in our midst. Hallelujah. We give Him glory. We greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus. And I continue to thank God. I know I was absent for 2 weeks, but the church does not belong to me. The owner of the church is Papa God. Can we give Him glory? Hallelujah. Because He's the one who is busy raising up His children to be in His service, that His kingdom can move forward. We thank God for what you have done. Papa David, Papa Henri, Mama Francine, the choir, all the church, Papa Paul, everything that you have done contributes to the advancement of the kingdom of God. Your reward is already there. I can tell you, faithfulness always pay. I can tell you, whatever the Lord asks you to do, it can be smaller or bigger, do it well. Hallelujah. It's not the applause of people, it's not the recognition of people, but God can see everything, and He will reward the church and everyone. Without delay, we are going to the message of today. Are you ready? Sense of God. Are you excited? Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I used to say, when the word of God is in His way toward you, you must be excited. Why? Because as the righteous people, we should live by faith. Hallelujah. This morning when I was praying for this service, I saw this wonderful day. A day that the Lord has made. I say, God, it's not you who made a day like this. It's not the devil. And the Bible says, whatever you have made is good. I pray that this good, this day, will be good in you. Will be good to anyone I will meet. It will be good for the church of God. Because you are the one who made it. Hallelujah. We were sleeping without knowing what is going on. As this day comes, whatever belongs to the past, let us leave it behind. And what you want to do for us today, let it be done into our life. Do you know our God is a good God? Hallelujah. You must know it. Because if you don't know it, you will remain in trouble and you will get stagnant somewhere. Let us read our scripture from today. Let us go in the Psalm 68. We will read verse 1. Psalm 68. Hallelujah. I will ask Papa Henri to stand first to read it in French. Just the first verse. And God will be glorified. Psalm 68. Verse 1. Hallelujah.
Amen. Je lis au nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Dieu se lève et ses ennemis se disparaissent et ses adversaires fuient devant sa face. Amen.
Amen. The Bible says, let go. Let his enemy be scattered. Hallelujah. Let God arise and his enemy be scattered. Let those also who ate him flee before him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today our subject is a big call just to command you. You know, if you are obedient to this commandment and you accept it, something will start to happen in your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, let God arise, let his enemy be scattered. So who ate him? Flee before him. At the end of this message, any enemies of your life, anyone who ate you, has to flee too. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Any enemies of your life, anyone who ate you, has to flee. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It will happen to you too. If you accept this command, because our subject is for you to be arise. Tell your neighbor, arise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wake up, arise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, we have to know that in any conflict, in any opposition, if you remain down, then you remain the failure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In any conflict, in any opposition, in any attack, when you are not arising and do anything, that means you are who? The loser and the failure. Tell your neighbor, not me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not me from today. You know, knowledge in any conflict, how to get victory, is very, very crucial and very important. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Knowledge is very, very important. Do you know what the Bible says about knowledge? Especially in the book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6. The Bible says the people of God has been destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Those that are not unbelievers, they are a people of God. You know, a people of God is the one who is in covenant with him. He is the one who God choose. He is a special one. Let me tell you, God can choose you to be a pastor. God can choose you to be a believer. God can choose you to be a Christian. But if you don't have any knowledge in the midst of any conflict, in the midst of any trouble, you don't know what to do, you can perish too. That will never be your portion. Because through the word of God, understanding, knowledge will come into your life. Once you respond to that, your life will never be the same again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now let me ask you a question. I want you to get this knowledge. Imagine God when he was sitting or sleeping, the enemy could not scatter. Even though they hate him, they could not
scatter.
There are people here, until you do something, the enemy will continue to mess up with your life. Opposition will continue to pull you down. Hallelujah. miracle happened. The enemy, they were rejoicing. Opposition were dancing. They think to be. Do you know when the lion rises up? How things can happen. Even things could be around him. They will notice. They say, this one, the way you wake up like this. We are in trouble. What they have to do? They have to vanish and disappear. Hallelujah. If that could happen to God, you and me right now, as born again believers, we have the nature of God. Hallelujah. Church of God, we must wake up. Believers of God, you must arise in your life, in your marriage, in your family. Don't let any enemy mess up with your life. Are you understanding me? Very, very important. You need to know that anything that can be against your glorious destiny, hallelujah, require you and me to arise that we may move on. Hallelujah. The devils don't like anything else except you and me to stand against it. Are you understanding? He doesn't understand other language. It's not your wishing, it's your standing against it that can help you to get the victory. And during this wonderful message, I want everybody in this place to understand that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't let that unpleasant situation continue to operate in your life. Hallelujah. There is some struggle since it starts in your life. It never ends. And you find it normal. You are coming to church. You can sing and say God is there. But still accepting that struggle. No, beloved. Are you understanding me? Don't continue in those big expressions. That you can apply into your life, and your life will never be the same again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I ask the church of God, it can be in your secular way, it can be in your studies. Listen, you cannot go to school, you cannot start a business day after day, you still be a failure. You accept even that, it becomes like your status. No, beloved. This is the time you have to wake up. I want everybody, wherever he is, go back in your mind. Start to check your life. See what things is going on and what is not going on. Hallelujah. Last time I was preaching in the first book of Corinthians chapter 6 verse
19,
where the Bible says our body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. We are not our own. God owns us. He possesses us. Because we have been bought by a price in order to give him glory. You know, when I understand as born again believer, a Christian coming to church, that I'm not my own, that means including my family, my possession, whatever that I'm doing right now, if my body that I can use to satisfy me and to do whatever I can do, right now it belongs to God. Why not by TV? Why not God to change the
time.
The God that can open that computer. The God that can drive the car.
Cars
on you.
Who
on that car? Are you understanding? And the Bible says, because he has been bought you by a price. Let me tell you, you are not of God for free. You know, most of the people, when you need something from them, they will give you what they don't like. Oh, because I'm not driving in this car. Instead of throwing away, let anyone take it. You know, the nature of God is not like that. When you want anything from God, he will give you his very best. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Romans chapter 8, verse 32. The Bible says he did not spare his son. His best. He did not spare him. He offered
him.
He delivered him for you and for me. And the reason why he delivered, the Bible says, why he cannot give us all things us all things. Hallelujah. He paid the price. The blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, during this Passover time, we are going at the end of this month of April. And the month of April, we celebrate Passover. We remind how we can really be the people of God. And what really we can do. It was a time we can be called a people of God, but still doing other things that cannot give God glory. But during a period like this, you must arise, you must wake up and understand your identity. You have to know that you are a temple of the Holy Spirit, not a temple of and through the price that you have been paid, let me tell you, you can light it or not. That blood speak on your behalf. The blood of Jesus is speaking on your behalf that you may come out from any chain. You may come out from any sickness. You may come out from any failure. That is the last bullet that will guard you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
During a time like this, God wants you, because he has paid the price. Listen to me. If you go to buy anything with your money, what is your intention beyond that? There is someone who can buy a car with money just for nothing. No. Whatever you can buy, it can be smaller or bigger, is to be used. Are you understanding? And you and me, for all your family to worship and to serve you. Tell your neighbor, if you are here and you didn't accept Jesus, it's for you to be used by God in one area or another, in your speech, in your behavior, in whatever we can do. Church of God, if we listen and understand this, it will help us. You know, you can spend in the morning. You say, I have been bought by a price in order to be used by God. God, I pray right now that I may stand in my calling. You who call me, you are a faithful. You who bought me with a price, you are a faithful. You are not a liar. Hallelujah. You have to stand on what you have been paid for. This is not a time. Anyone in this place, according to this word, must remain in captivity. This is a time of freedom. You have to move in order to reach your destiny. Because of what God has done. Because of His word. Because of His offer. This is a time. Hallelujah. You know, there is some situation that can happen into your life. Until you learn to stand, you will never be out. Who is captive somewhere? Who can be in prison somewhere? It can be a prison of sickness. It can be a prison, I don't know what. You are blocked somewhere, you cannot come. There is thing you cannot see normal. Years after years, you are praying, you are coming to church. Things does not work. You want to tell me that God is a liar? He said he does not show any partiality. Special for those that can fear him. Hallelujah. He does not show any discrimination. How he can bless others and not you? He's not an unjust God. He's a righteous one. We will need something that can help us to understand. Because you are a so-called a people of God, a chosen one, the devil does not like that. You know, when Adam was planted in the Garden of Eden, the devil did not like what he did. He do his best to pull them out of the garden. Because once they can lose the presence of God, he can mess up with the life and do whatever he wants. It's what he's doing right now. He knows that you are a special one. Hallelujah. He knows that you have eternity. He has a short time. Do you know that the devil has a short time? Do you think the devil will be happy to see you have eternity? Want you and Eve to end up in hell. Are you understanding me? Let me tell you, when you accept Jesus, hallelujah, the Bible says you receive eternal life, but He has a short time. He can break, operate right now. He knows that it's a short time. He's catching his time because he don't like to be alone. Sit in heaven. He fell with other angels. Even right now, if you are not aware, he's in that business. Every time you see the life of God in you, you see the eternal life in you. He's mad with you. He's not your friend. Don't cope with the devil. Are you understanding me? He's looking after the best that is already in you. He's looking for the best that is planted in you. Christ.
Alléluia. Let us go in the book of Matthew, please. Chapter 13. Alléluia. There is a lot that the Lord has done into our midst, into our life. There is a lot of promises God continues to preach, to speak into us. Alleluia. From verse 24 to down, the Bible says, Matthew 13, Verse 24. Let us read. Another parable he put forth to them, saying, the kingdom of God is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But when men slept, his enemy came and sowed there among the wheat. And went his way. But when the grain exploded and produced a
cob,
then the birds also appeared. So the servant of the owner came and said to him, sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? How then does it have a bad one? He said to them, an enemy has done this. Let me tell you, God is putting good seed in you. And we know the word of God is the incorruptible seed. Now why in the food that come out of your life, out of your church, out of your man, God can plant the good. He came, he put the best. Why there is the bad coming? That means there is an enemy somewhere. Do you know that? How the enemy took advantage. The Bible says, when you are sleeping, when you are not awake, the enemy take advantage. Hallelujah. I told you that anything contrary to your good, let me tell you, anything contrary to your good is the product of the enemy. Any good and best and perfect is what comes from God. Check your life. Maybe you don't know. But you have to know, because if you think that God can give you a bad business, God cannot give you a bad life. God cannot give you a bad business. Oh my God. Because God is the giver of good. Hallelujah. That means there is an enemy. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. Bible says, be sober and vigilant, watchful, because your enemy, the adversary, is like a roaring lion looking for who he may devour. Let me tell you, he knows the very best that is in you. He's looking over the church. He's looking over those that are following God. He's looking. He wants to find them sleeping. If they are not sober or vigilant, if they are not awake. Hallelujah. They sleepy, sleepy. Wakey, wakey. When he's looking for them, anytime you are in those states, you are letting him to get access. Are you understanding? Once he gets access, he does not come to play. Even there is a good seed already in you, even there is already promises in you, he will start to make sure he wants to establish also a seed in you.
Hallelujah. But you will notice that by saying, I was praying to be saved. I was praying to be healed. I was praying to be saved. I was praying to be blessed. Why these kind of things happen? When you see that, you must shake up yourself. Shake from your dust. You may be who you are. Are you understanding me? Don't be a sleepy Christian. Hallelujah. There are people sometimes when they sleep, they forget about
that.
Hallelujah. It's when the devil enters. Are you understanding? A church that is sleeping, the devil will enter. A marriage that is sleeping, the devil will enter. Are you understanding me?
Amen.
You know, we must be a church who arise. Hallelujah. When we say we have prayer, hallelujah.
Amen.
Even without shoes, we say today we will pray. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we say we have to pray, say, nobody.
You
must save God. Because He has been paid the price. In your mind, and you are doing that, I can tell you, you will never be disappointed. There will never be a disease. Oh, you know, a disease is what is not
peace.
Hallelujah. Because what comes from God must be easy. Because of the price He has been paid. In a such period like this, busy celebrating is to help you to serve God. Hallelujah. But always the enemy does not
fight.
I was preaching in South Africa last time. I was talking about how Pharaoh used to use people. You know, when Moses went to
Egypt,
Exodus chapter 10, we don't have the time to read. Hallelujah. You know, Pharaoh, what he said, after God doing all those blood, those wonders, for Pharaoh to let his people go, to go to serve him and to worship. You know what Pharaoh did? He accepted the deal. He said to Moses, because you want to praise God to serve him, I accept now. Take only all the men. Hallelujah. I will give you a good place. You will go to worship God.
Instead
to die, you must understand that you have family too. It was the best offer. It was like He accepted them to do what they want. There are people here, it seems like God wants them to change. But He don't release you totally. There still be a link from you to Him. That you can come 10 times and you will go back to Him 10 times. That is not normal. Do you know what Moses said? He refused. He said, not only men with wives. You know, Pharaoh would say, okay.
He
was negotiating. Sometimes we don't negotiate with
you.
There is a lot of proposition. You
say,
you know what you are doing? It's not just a sin. You know, if you can just go to the church and continue to do that, it's okay. Let me tell you. Because you see a terminal in you. You see the life of God in you. He wants to
walk.
He's a robber. He don't like what you are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, Moses said no. You must be a radical Christian. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One time he said, you can go with wives, but not children. You know, children, they are weak. Most of the time when we say we have prayer, there are many people they don't come because the children they are too weak. You know, especially in this country, it's like I'm disturbing them. Oh, you know, I did not come because of the children, because of this and that. Moses said, no! Men, women, children, we have to go. Hallelujah.
Yes.
We have to go. But Pharaoh did not say. He said, okay. Let us make a deal. Go with wife. Go with children. But not go with the cattle, the animals. Moses said, ah. How can we go to save God without the sacrifice? Let me tell you. That is the wills of the enemy. It's the wills of the enemy. He tries to tell you, you can go to church, leave your wife behind. When you leave your wife behind, your wife will be an instrument, weaker sleep, when the devil will plant his seed to damage your family. When you are coming to church, even your faith will be down. You say, ah, this is not my children. Because you left them behind. I'm talking to a child right now. Never. If it depends on you, never. This is a place sometimes. Because in here we don't have cow. We're supposed to bring the cow here. The devil does not like you to reach the destiny. He does not like that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The only language he understood is resistance. Hallelujah. But before you resist it, according to James chapter 4, verse 7, submit to God. But they are not submissive. Oh, let me tell you. Before you call, you can answer. Obedient. Let me tell you. Obedient is a mark to punish disobedience. Oh, my God. Obedient is a mark. Before you call,
the
answer only. That answer is not for everybody. That answer is for those that obey
you.
God tell me to say to you this morning, there are a couple here. You are praying for peace. You know, when you are obedient, even before you pray for peace, peace will take place. Because the submission of the wife in the house, hallelujah, can bring peace in the home. Are you understanding me? You are not submissive. You can go to the queue of prayer, to the line of prayer. You can look men of God wherever you want, until you learn to be submissive in your mind, not
submissive.
Are you understanding me? It's not the queue of prayer. You can go for 40 days. Because I know the Lord that you are saving. When we pray, the Bible says, whoever asks, it shall be given. I know when I stay in prayer, asking God to intervene, I know it is the act of obedience. But we have to do it by obedience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because before we call, he will answer. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse
3.
The weapon that we are using, they are spiritual. They are mighty to pull down all strong. Do you know that? The weapon that we are using is too strong and mighty in God. Hallelujah. Those weapons to punish all disobedience. When your obedience become complete, you refuse to submit to God. But do you expect that things will happen? No. Are you understanding me? There is things. Let me tell you. Most of the time, miracle happen in the life of someone. It's not the amount of prayer. Hallelujah. It's the amount of right prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, prayer is not just talking. There is a meaning behind it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you know how the first miracle happened? You know, many told the disciples, whatever he commands you to do, just do it. I'm talking to someone like
you.
If you want to see the miracle happen, if God commands you to pray, don't discuss. Don't bring discussion in that. Say, yes, God, you command me that men should always pray. For today, you are my boss. I say, yes, let me pray. Are you understanding me? God said you have to pray. Men should always pray.
You
should say, let me see. The Bible
says
always. You want to see miracle in what you are praying. What you have to do? Whatever he commands you. Tell your neighbor, just do it. Hallelujah. You go at all. The atmosphere is saturated. What God commands you to do, he says, cast out. You, instead of casting out that thing, you start to cry. Oh Lord, there they are coming again. Lord, they are coming. You are not doing what they
do.
You know, your obedience is not complete. How do you think on the air go? You must check your life.
Say,
there is a seed of the enough. That cat will go. Because that miracle happened. Because you are doing what God commanded. Church of God. This time is the time of obeying and doing what God commanded. Any refuser to do that, bring deception, bring frustration, and you will be deceived because you refuse. Hallelujah. Because I know you should live by faith, by what God plans in you. But when you check around you, the product is not what God wants. That means there is a problem. Hallelujah. I'm asking you to be alive. What could happen if Jesus could remain in the tomb? We could call him a winner, a champion. No. Do you know that? You know what did terrify the devil? Is when Jesus came out of the tomb. How he came out of the tomb? He was sleeping, stay in the tomb. Okay, let me sleep here. The devil will know that I'm in the kingdom. No. It was when he arrived. He's coming out. He's coming out. The devil made him fail. He was down. He refused to remain there. First day. Second day. The Bible says the same power that rescues from his folly. Maybe right now it's sin that makes you fail down. You remain a failure because you let that sin continue. Are you understanding me? You remain a failure because you let that sin let you remain down. A champion is the one who can fail, but is not remain on the ground.
Yes.
All champions, they fail somewhere. You know, they can kick you, you fail. They can score you fail. But when you raise up, you start to go against, you can get back your
life.
Are you understanding
me?
Jesus,
yes.
When the devil comes, he kicked him. He fell too. But he did not remain there. Why do you can remain there? Years after years, you still praise him in that
room.
You still worship him in that room. Which kind of glory you are giving
him?
Wake up, wake up, wake up. God is calling you to arise. He's a faithful to that calling. I can tell you, he's a faithful to that calling. Before we close, I want you to read Proverbs verse 24.
Verse
16. Very wonderful scripture. Not only apply for sin, but it can be applied for everything that makes you fall down. Proverbs 24.
Proverbs 24.
Verse 16.
Verse 16.
Are you there, beloved? Are you learning something? Can we shout praise?
Hallelujah.
Praise the living God.
Proverbs 24.
Verse 16.
Verse 16.
The Bible says, for a righteous man may fall 7 times. I like the way the English presents it. May fall. Let me tell you. You can be a righteous man. Sometimes you can fall
too.
Do you know that? Because this is the scripture. This is a righteous man. The Bible says a righteous man may fall 7 times.
same time.
But rise again and rise again. But the wicked shall fall by calamity. That is forever. Imagine you are coming to church. You fail in sin and you remain in sin forever. According to this scripture, we will call you a wicked one. Hallelujah. But when you fail, you say, I'm so dirty. How I can be a child of God and be in the mob like this? Let me wake up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Bible says, I cannot remain there. Let me wake up. When you wake up, we cannot call you the failure or the wicked one. We still call you the righteous one. Because you refuse to remain down. I'm preaching to someone. Refuse in your life to remain down under any bit of the devil. I'm not only talking about sin. It could be on sickness. You failed yesterday. Don't remain there. You must come. There is a scripture in Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 2. God is saying something that is very important. I want you to understand. Let us go there. Isaiah 43. Hallelujah. Isaiah 43, verse 1 and 2. Maybe you think, oh, pastor is saying this for himself. No, I get it from the Bible. The Bible says, but now, are you there? Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 2. But now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the water, I will be with you. And through the river, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you down. Listen. God said, He's the one who created you. He's the one who redeemed you. He's the one who gave you name. He's the one who formed you. I know right now, God is busy forming you. That means, welfare is a reality. Conflict, trouble is a reality. But victory is also a reality. Trouble will be there. Fire can come to quench. Conflict will be there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible does not say if you go. It's not a condition. It's a when you go. That means to anyone, there is some stage of your life. Hallelujah. But my God, my Redeemer, you can applaud me or not. Hallelujah. You can applaud me or not. But what I know, things can happen. And Jesus rose. Hallelujah. You know, when you say, I'm not my own anymore, I'm slave. I let him to be my boss. The one who is your boss, who is anointing, Do you know the anointing of God will destroy the yoke in you? Because you let that anointing be your boss. It's not the demon who directs you, who guides you. It's the Spirit of God. You cannot let the Spirit of God guide and lead you and remain on the same
thing.
No, beloved. No matter what. There is an operation of the Spirit of God in your life. Let me tell you, you have
come
out. Hallelujah. Don't remain in that position. Hallelujah. I will close by that. I want you and me. Most of the time, we are aware of demonic spirits, but we forget about good spirits, not demon, angel spirits. There are some spirits God created them to help you. Hallelujah. When Jesus was on the tomb, the Bible says in Matthew 28, verse 2, that the angel of God came. They rolled back the stone that broke the door. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are some spiritual beings, angelical beings, that God can dispatch for His word that was planted into your life to come to life. Hallelujah. I want this morning, when we will raise up to prayer, we will engage those angelical beings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus, when he was praying, he gets weak. He could not stand after 40 days of fasting. But the Bible says God sent his angel to strengthen him, that he can go again, save God, and do what he's supposed to do. I can see angels dispatch on your behalf right now, help you to achieve your mission. Just get ready. I know the Holy Spirit is here. Saint Spirit is found in
me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
No one will go out of this place because there is the presence of God. Angel will be dispatched on your behalf. Not only for you alone, even for your brother and your sister, your wife, your children, who is not here. Because
Lot
was in Sodom. That's why most of the time when we call you to come to the night prayer, you must come instead of you sleeping. Because it was at night when Abraham was praying, God sent an angel in Sodom. Sodom was supposed to be destroyed. But before that, the angel went collecting
Lot
to remove him. You know, Jesus said, when they come to catch him, in order to be killed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Peter cut the ears of one of soldiers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know what Jesus said? He looked those soldiers. He said, "You are nothing. I will just accept for you to catch me, to let the scripture to be fulfilled." He said something that was very important. He said, "I will pray my father, he will send me 12 legions of angels. There is no one who can resist me." That means even myself, I can't do nothing. But when I can stand strongly in my prayer and ask the intervention of angelical beings, you soldier, you are nothing. Are you understanding? You soldier, you are nothing. But I accept because I have the right to all.
to lay down my life and to get it back in order to fulfill the
same.
You are not there to let the devil mess up. When you remain, your mouth closed, you are not standing against whatever attack is when you remain in those
places.
But when you realize that you can stand in a
place,
hallelujah. When you realize that the Holy Spirit is there, when you realize that you are not your own, the blood of Jesus has been paid for. When you realize, you want to take advantage of what the Lord has done, is then your future will be better. I like everyone wherever you are.